Hello everyone, welcome back again to my channel with Farley here, Farley from Primary 3 and Jazz Academy Bojong Indah. Today I will explain the layer of the atmosphere on Earth. Let's go. Number 1, troposphere. This layer is caused to the Earth's surface. It is located 8 to 14 kilometers from the Earth's surface. Tropos come from the ancient Greek word which means change name. Tropos because the activity in this layer constantly changing, the changing weather, the wind, the air we breathe, and the cloud exists in the troposphere. In fact, three quarter of the mass of the atmosphere is in the troposphere. The higher you go, the colder the air. Number 2, stratosphere. After the troposphere, there is the stratosphere, the boundary of this layer reach and altitude of 50 kilometers with a thickness of up to 35 kilometers. Its name comes from the word threat, which means layer. So in the stratosphere there is another layer, the opposite side of the troposphere. The air in the lower layer of the stratosphere and get hotter when it is above. Number 3, mesosphere. Up again, there is the mesosphere, given the name meso or middle because of its position in the middle. It is about 35 thick or located at an altitude of 50 kilometers to 85 kilometers. The air in this layer is so thin that we cannot breathe when we reach this layer, but there are more gases than oxygen in this layer. Number 4, thermosphere. Above the mesosphere, there is the thermosphere. Thermo means hot, still describing the temperature of this layer. Temperature in the thermosphere can be reached 1500 degrees Celsius. But if we get here, we'll feel cold because there is no molecular gas to conduct heat to our body. It also means that sound waves cannot be heard. Number 5, ionosphere. Well, unlike the other layer, the ionosphere is a unique layer because of its tacked position in the mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. This layer moves and oscillates depending on the energy it absorbs from the sun. Exosphere. Number 6, exosphere. The furthest and thickest is the exosphere. This layer is called the exo because it's the outermost layer. No one has been established a definite boundary between the outermost layer of the atmosphere and outer space, but NASA uses the 10,000 kilometer limit. The exosphere only stores gases such as hydrogen and helium, but the gases were scattered with a wide distance. The furthest and thickest is the exosphere. This layer is called the exo because it is the outermost layer. No one has established a definite boundary between the outermost layer of the atmosphere and outer space, but NASA uses the 10,000 kilometers limit. The exosphere only stores gases such as hydrogen and helium, but the gases were scattered with a wide distance. Bye bye. See you in my next video channel, ya guys. Bye bye.